Most people don't know about enum views in SwiftUI because they are rarely mentioned in tutorials or documentation. Yet, they offer a powerful way to organize and manage your UI. In this video, I will show you exactly how to unlock the full potential of enum views, making your SwiftUI code cleaner, more scalable, and easier to maintain. Let's dive in and give your app architecture a serious upgrade. And if you want to learn SwiftUI in just 4 weeks, go ahead and check out the discounted link in the description. More on this later in the video. Now, today we are going to talk about enums and more specifically enum views. Now, maybe you haven't heard about this. This is why I'm making this tutorial. You can make enum views. What are the use cases of enum views? Well, let's say you have a fetch on the server and you might get back a success value with some results or whatever. Maybe most importantly, it is a valid call. You are a success. You have a success result. Or you might get back an error. And you want to have some sort of a mechanism set in place for the views to handle all of these. So you might present a success view, maybe a text, or if an error came in, you want to present that error's localized description. And it could be really cumbersome to make this over and over and over again inside your all of your views. So here comes enum views to the rescue. So let's just type this out and you will get the whole picture after you watch the whole video. Thinking about getting better at SwiftUI? Now's the perfect time. SwiftUI Camp is my live cohort-based Zoom bootcamp where you'll go way beyond the basics and actually learn how to build real production-ready iOS apps. We'll work together over 4 weeks with structured lessons, hands-on projects, and a ton of support to make sure you actually get it. Enrollment's open right now for 80% off for only $199, but only till May the 7th. After that, the price goes back up. If you're ready to finally feel confident with SwiftUI, grab your spot. Link is in the description. So, two things that we need to create right over here. First is we're going to create a result view with the success and error result enum, to be more precise. And then we are going to just use it. I'm just having a button right over here just to simulate the is result successful state. And we can just see those two views switch between themselves. Okay, so first things first, let's create our enum. So here we go. It's a result view. And let's just have two cases right over here. Case success. And then case failure, that's fine. We are going to use that. And I'm just going to pass along an error. Now, of course, you might want to pass along, if that is the case, some values on the success case. That's totally up to you. You can do the same thing as we're going to do the one with the error. Okay, so yeah, pretty straightforward. We have our result view enum. Now comes the real interesting part. Enums can also adhere to the view protocol. Remember, this is a view protocol. The content view struct adheres to the view protocol, which means that it has to have a body variable of some view. Okay, so let's just add that view. Now we need to adhere to the view protocol. We are going to see an error. It says type result view does not conform to protocol view. So we need to add, you know, it requires the body. I'm just going to type it out, body, and then just use this one. Oh, not the type alias, body. And that's right. Okay, so it's already suggesting some things, and indeed, this is perfectly fine. So let's just go through this. I'm going to hit a tab right over here. We are switching through self. Self is an enum. So we'd have two cases, the success value, success case and the failure case, which in turn has an error. If we have, if the enum, if self is successful, it's the case of success, we are going to present, we are going to have this as the view of text of success. Otherwise, we are going to present error, and let's just have the localized description so it's much more readable. So this enum, indeed, is an enum, we can just go result view dot success and result view dot dot failure error, and you can just switch through that like we did right over here. But also we can use it as a view. So let's do that. Let's just scroll all the way down right over here, and let's just have an if is result successful. We are going to go and present our result view dot success indeed. Else, we are going to go and present our result view dot failure. Yeah, and just the custom NS error right over here. That's just perfectly fine. Whatever, you know, just going to pass along our error. So now let's build and run, and let's see how it looks like. Here we go. Now let's just take a look at this. The isResult successful is set to false, therefore it should present this view. And indeed, error, the operation could not be completed, error of code 0. Now let's toggle it. And it's success. Now, you see, it's just changing the view according to our enum type. Let's just do that again. It's really, really nice. Amazing. Again, let's just recap. We have two cases on the enum, and you might have multiple cases right over here. A success, a failure, and we are passing along some data. It could be also on the success, by the way. And then we are just switching through, you know, in this case it's just a true or false, but it could just switch through all of the cases of the result view. And then we are just presenting the view, and the beauty of it is that it looks really nice. Like this is like just a switch case, result view dot success, which in turn is a view. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out also SwiftUI Camp. 4 weeks, you will learn SwiftUI. Go ahead and check out the link in the description.